This module is an introduction to coordination compounds. So a coordination compound has coordinate covalent bonds in it. A coordinate covalent bond is a bond where both of the electrons in that bond came from one atom and it's shared with another atom. That's as opposed to what we normally see where when we make a covalent bond, one atom on each side of the bond is donating an electron. So here, this is a cobalt 2 ion and it's forming coordinate bonds, coordinate covalent bonds to these three ammonia molecules, these six ammonia molecules out here. This is a complex ion, saw a little bit of in another topic. So this here ion, this complex ion, has a cobalt 2 metal, six molecules of ammonia, each of these forming a coordinate covalent bond to the cobalt atom. And has an overall +3, this is cobalt 3, not cobalt 2. A lot of times when you have a coordinate compound, there's a counter ion along with a complex ion. So in this case, it might be something like the chloride ion. So if we had three chloride ions out here, you could write the formula either like this or like this. The ion, the complex ion, looks like the formula is this. So we could either write the complex ion like this, just like this, in brackets with three chloride ions outside. Or we could write it like this. Both of these mean the same thing. This is just a model of what it looks like. There's the cobalt 3 ion. Each of these three ammonia molecules is donating a pair of electrons to the cobalt 3 ion. Remember, in ammonia, NH3, the nitrogen has a lone pair of electrons. That's the electrons that are making this bond right here. So the ions or molecules that form these coordinate covalent bonds to the metal are called ligands. And these are just some examples of ligands. We saw ammonia there, carbon monoxide, chloride can be a ligand, cyanide, thiocyanate, water can even do that, ethylamine. By the way, you'll see this in a little bit. The abbreviation for ethylene diamine is EN. Oxalate and EDTA. You hear a lot about this, ethylene diamine tetraacetate ion. Looks like this guy right here. We'll look at this a little bit in a second. So ones that the species that donate the electrons to the metal atom in the middle are called ligands. These are some examples. A ligand, because it's donating a pair of electrons, is acting as a Lewis base. Remember, Lewis base is an electron pair donor, and Lewis acid is an electron pair acceptor. And so the metal is accepting a pair of electrons, it's being a Lewis acid, which means that a ligand has to have at least one pair of unshared electrons to act as a ligand. That in the ligand, so some of these ligands can get fairly large, relatively speaking. The atom, the specific atom that donates the electrons to the metal that forms the bond, that's called the donor atom. So this right here is ethylene diamine tetraacetate ion with a lead atom in the middle here. And this oxygen here, all these guys are donating electrons. When we talk about coordination numbers for a coordination compound, that's just telling how many atoms are, donor atoms are surrounding the central metal atom. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 atoms donating electrons to the central metal atom. So the coordination number for this compound would be 6. We classify these ligands as monodentate, bidentate, or polydentate based on how many donor atoms they have, right? So these are monodentate ligands, all these guys. This can only form a bond there. This is too small to wrap around. It can only donate the electrons from the oxygen and the carbon, but not both at the same time. Chloride, cyanide, same idea. Thiocyanate, water. Bidentate, examples would be ethylene diamine. Oxalate. So this is going to be, you know, two of these oxygens will be able to be donor atoms. Polydentate, EDTA. So we've got this oxygen, this oxygen, this oxygen, this oxygen, and like we saw, you could also have this nitrogen and this nitrogen here. This over here is ethylene diamine being the ligand. The donor atoms would be the nitrogens, so there and there. Now, if we look at this guy, this is cobalt 2 in the middle this time. Now, this right here is one ligand. It's ethylene diamine with two donor atoms. This is another ligand, another ethylene diamine, and this is a third. So that's the three right here. The coordination number for this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each ethylene diamine has two donor atoms on it. You're going to want to, when we get to naming these guys, you're going to need to know the oxidation state of the transition metal in the complex ion. And you can do this just the way we do oxidation states normally. Knowing, for example, here, we need to know, it ends up, we'll need to know the oxidation state for gold here. So we know hydroxide's -1, and there's four of these, 4 times -1. We know potassium's +1, and there's no charge, so all the oxidation states must add up to 0. And so the only thing we don't know is gold. Solving for gold, we get +3. So the oxidation state for gold here is +3. In this compound right here, ruthenium, there's ammonia, there's water, and there's chloride ions. So we know there's two chloride ions, each is -1, ruthenium. I'm not putting anything here for ammonia because that doesn't have a charge and water doesn't have a charge. They're all 0. And ruthenium ends up being +2 here.